Yo, hello, hi, how's it going? Oh, I'm seeing some ones in chat. Good to see everyone back. The number one community on YouTube, that's you guys. Thank you very much for being here. Thanks for smashing like. Means a absolutely. It certainly means a lot to have your support. So thank you. Welcome. Good to see you here. Hello. Hi. Hi. Hello. Ooh, look at all the blue hi emotes. Beautiful. Hey, what's up, Skull? How you doing, dude? Welcome back. Beautiful. Good to see you all here. Yep, Frontier Pilot Simulator has a newer update. It's been a while since we've taken a look at it, so we're checking it out tonight. And I'm going to be flying with the PS4 controller tonight for the first time, so that should be pretty good. What's that? What? You're getting a message on Discord. It's telling you that you can click or tap join and become a member right now by smashing that join button. You'll get a lot of access to incredible perks, such as the ability to, well, jump into our members-only section of the Discord. And also win a lot of free games for free giveaways? Yeah, that's right. Just click or tap join today. I'll put a message in the chat so that way everybody can find it. And then we will begin our stream. You're already a member? Good. Very good. Let's see if we can get a join pyramid from every one of our members. Let's see if you guys can stack them high. And I will type my little message so people can find the join button easily. Let's see. There we go. We'll throw that in there. Get those join pyramids going. Good. Very good. Very good. Excellent, members. Good. Good. Beautiful. Oh, and Discord also says you're cool. Yep. Says here in this message. Yep. Beautiful. Welcome back, nerds. Good to see you all here. Hopefully you're all enjoying the start of your weekend. Wow, look at those join pyramids. Good. Very good. Maybe we'll get some ramen emotes and stuff. All right, we're going to listen to some random YouTube music off the Susan Safe playlist. Let's, in the meantime, turn up some of the other sounds. We'll see how this goes. Hopefully it's not too loud. Okay, let's see, I have a couple profiles saved from before. Wait, they're both the same? Let's load Alpha. And I'll have to remember how to fly again. So, I don't know what the name of this planet is, I always forget, but essentially it's like a planet that is going through like a biosphere has changed or something like that, and there's like these old oceans that are now deserts and deserts that are now oceans, and you could deliver stuff all over the map. It's now available on Steam, and I've taken a look at it every so often, and it's always nice to, like we usually do on the channel, take a look at new updates, that type of thing. What is chat's favorite molecule? I think chat's favorite molecule is the like button. I think they're all, because they're always spamming that blue thumbs up in chat, too. They're always doing that. Bum, 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 bum. Or at least that's what I'm told. Bum. Oh boy. Oh cool, that's right, you can customize your ship now. I forgot about that. And I think we're completely broke in this game because I spent all my money on stuff to transport. Alright, let's see if we can remember how to fly. Or actually, can we buy cargo? I gotta learn the controls again, let's see. Circle, that lets us see the weather. Switch targets. Toggle landing gear, okay. Oh, actually, landing gear is automatic in this game. So I want to pick up some cargo, so I think we have to roll back into this thing. There we go. And we can transport things around. So that's battery charge. All right, what about jobs? Map displays the area. Ah, there we go. So we're on this, like, tiny planet that's, like, basically Space Iceland. Or no, sorry, we're on this tiny little island. Like, it's the tutorial island, but the real main island is this. where it's like Mars, basically. And we're using the smallest transport in the game, which is probably a good idea so I can remember how to play. And then eventually, we will go off and transport stuff elsewhere. Let's see. Well, that's like a map. But I want to see the available stuff to buy. I guess that's the only thing here now. All right, let's go to... we'll set a course to go buy rations down here that they're telling us. Actually, I don't think we have a single penny. Oh, yeah, we actually owe money. I'm negative $950 in the game. Oops, my bad. Oops. That's a big oofs. Oofs. Not oops, but oofs. Oof. That's a big oof. What else can I transport from here? Contacts. Is that like a... The contacts and messages. Ah, there we go. Trade. So we want to start at Bora. And it looks like they'll let us transport stuff here, Fragile. I guess we have to go, we can go a little bit more into debt. Oh, this is what they need. Otherwise, we can transport a passenger. Let's do that. We'll do a little transport passenger. Is that where we pick him up from? Trade at Bora. I think we pick him up here and then transport him south, but it doesn't seem like it's... no, the music's not in game. It's this weird YouTube playlist. There is music in the game, though, but it's kind of like intermittent. Oh, that's who we're looking to pick up. All right. And how do we go into first person? I'll just use my keyboard. Nope. There is a first person, though. Well, that's, Well, there is a way to go into first person. It is pretty sweet. Although I can't remember what the keyboard control is for it. Alright, we gotta go pick this lady up. There's a lot of VTOL takeoff and landings in this game. But there's also runways and stuff, too, and that's a lot of fun to use. All right, how do I, like, pick this lady up? Left shoulder and Y for the loading ramp. Oh, I see. Yep, come on, man. Oh, there we go. That's how to change that. Ah, okay, perfect. Those R1 and X. Cool. Okay, ma'am, do you want to get on board? Use D-pad to activate this panel. Good afternoon, I need to get to Bridgeport. Can I count on your help? Yes. Oh, there she goes. It's weird playing with a controller, but it's definitely a lot more... It's gooder.
Attention, Bab. Yeah, pick off bit. Yeah, make sure you click tap like button. Bab, new subscriber. Click tap join, become a member today. Today's in flight meal will be top ramen, pizza rolls, and hot pockets. Prepare the cabin for takeoff.
Oh boy, flying this is going to be a little different. Oh boy, not there. Wait, what's going on with the camera? Oh, there we go. Alright, ma'am needs to go to Bridgeport. So this will at least start us getting out of debt. There's three sizes of aircraft in this game. This is the smallest one, known as the Scarab, but there's a big boy in the game known as the bull, I think, or the ox or something. You want to buy one of these to get to work quicker? Yeah, it certainly would be nice to take an airplane to work, huh? Unless you work at the airport.
Welcome to our growing center. Our training floors are at your service.
Pretty smooth landing. Oh, that was actually really good. Nice. It should have been more centered out, but that was still good. Actually, wait. We didn't even need to land here. Just anywhere is fine. How do I go back into that first person? There we go. Yay, now we can taxi. Or wait. Oh, wait. This is another guy that wants to be picked up? Oh, wait. This is the place I need. Appreciate it. Could you please let me out? There's no escape, ma'am. Yes. Hey, buddy, want to take me to Port Estel? Sure. Hold on, bro. Let me pull up, bro. Is that an android? He's walking like an android. Wait, hold on, sir. I'm remembering. Sir? Okay, wait, or ma'am, sir? Wait, calling this Jane Addams. Okay, ma'am. You could be an android. I don't even know. I'm trying to remember the control for the... Uh-oh. Okay, I'm doing the bio scan. Okay. Oh, there it goes. Okay, that's part one done. Okay, now... Fine, hop on, ma'am. Set destination as target. We're not going to target, ma'am. Wait, what is Y on the PlayStation controller? Oh, boy. Oh, there it goes. Okay, it's triangle. Cool. Wait, that's 6 kilometers. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute, ma'am. We're gonna have to buy some gas, and I gotta figure out how to go into pilot mode. Hold on, ma'am. We gotta make a pick stop. We gotta pick up some ramen. That's what it is. Raptor leads a cult on YouTube. Yes. You can tell it's a cult anytime I say spam ramen in chat, and then there's a bunch of ramen emotes in chat. That's usually a good indicator of a cult. Oh, that was a damn fine landing right there. Or pretty close to it. Let's scoot over a little bit. Okay. How do I turn off engines now? Oh, there it goes. So we gotta fuel up, and then I gotta remember how to go into like flight mode for this thing. We might actually, I don't know if we can make it. Because we got to go like 6 kilometers. Yeah, I've got what I need now. But now I gotta remember how to go into flight mode. Because that saves fuel after a VTOL takeoff. Let's see. Flight mode, flight one. Hey, Marmello with the three. Thanks, dude. Hashtag Marmello in chat. Square. No, I think it's a button combo. Oh, there it is. VTOL and airplane mode switched, or pitch. It's 2 and X. Oh, wait, that's the pitch, though. Yeah, it's a button combo to go in and out of that mode. Is it 2 and X? Let's see. No, it's not. There's a hotkey for it, but I don't remember what it is. Or maybe this craft doesn't have it, but I think it does. We gotta figure that out before we go, otherwise we won't make it. Hello from Germany. Well, hello. Yeah, if you're watching now and you haven't subbed, that's kind of sus. Make sure you click that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell. Let's see. Wait. Interfaces. Oh, shift modes. That's it. Keypad negative. Maybe that's it. Let's see. I can't quite remember. It's been a while. It'll be kind of bad if we start going and run out of fuel. Oops, my bad. Landing gear. Let's see. At least we're getting better with the landings. Let's see. Press space to ult. Thrust fly up as space shift. WASD to go reverse. Okay, yep. How to trade. How to perform repairs. Pick up cargo. Ship systems. Radar battery hull. Okay. Release flaps. Oh, there it is. Shift. Switch between VTOL and airplane mode. Wait, with the D-pad? Uh-oh. Maybe that's it. Actually, we don't even have to go that far. I thought it was like all the way across the map, but Skull! Gotta go, but keep up the streams, Raptor. Thanks, dude. Hashtag Skull in chat. Thank you very much, dude, for the support. We don't have to go that far. This plane, I don't know if this one actually has the ability to go into VTOL mode, but... I mean, landing mode or whatever. Well, so far so good though. Oh, here we go. This area actually has a runway. A very small one, but we can actually take off from it if we want to. So it will function like an airport. That's cool. Too much. That's fine. Wait, what the hell? Oh, apparently I had landing gear on off rather than auto. Oops, my bad. There we go. That's fine. That'll buff out. All right, let's refuel. And we should be able to drop off that passenger, too. Let's see. Wait, how do you toggle auto? Ah, there it goes. And we should be able to buy fuel from here. That, I don't know where that lady wants to be dropped off at, though. Yes, we're being number ones right now. Yep, you can repair damage, and there's more ships than just this one, and you can customize ships, too, which is pretty cool. I guess it's not detecting that I'm parked. The engines are still burning fuel. We gotta turn that off. There we go. All right, ma'am, you're free to go. And now we can refuel. Recharge. Wow. We have exactly 50 credits. That's enough for some Wendy's, I think. What if we can actually... I think we can go to a station to change our ship now. Are we getting ones in chat for everybody who's turned on the notification bell and been here since the beginning of the stream? Is that what you guys are doing? Oh, good. So a lot of you already know what we're doing. Okay, good. Good. Very good. Yeah, I'd hate if we had somebody who was watching right now who wasn't subbed with the notification bell on and missed the beginning of the stream. That would be horrible, wouldn't it, chat? Oh, could you imagine that? Let's go back to where we came from and get a different ship. Our target is over there now. Gotta watch out for volcanoes, though.
New subscriber shout out.
Mortal Skull, thanks for subbing. And turning on that notification bell. Awesome. Now, is this where we can get our bigger ship? I think so. Landing gear came out late. There we go. All right, let's see what other ships we have access to. Boom, baby. Very cool. Marmella with the 149, thank you. All right, let's change ships. So I'll show you some of the other ships too. Oh, wait a minute. Apparently we have to buy these? I already have some of these. Where would I find if I have my other ship? Maybe it's in storage. Zion, thanks for subbing. We'll see. Daniel Campbell has become a Raptor hatchling. Daniel, dude, thank you very much. Big old crazy shout out to you for clicking the tab of that join button. Thank you very much for the support. That is fantastic. Thank you very much. I bet he also has the notification bell turned on, and I bet he's subscribed too. Wow. That's some big brains right there. That's beautiful. I wonder if there's a way to see other stored ships in storage. View ships available for purchase. I must have my other ships stored somewhere. Let's take a look. I think we have one of our bigger ships stored like here. I wonder if you can see where your other ships are stored. I know we got more around here somewhere. Smiley TM, indeed. Wow, Joe Mafro becoming a Raptor Egg as well. Thank you very much. Big O Coveted shout out to you. Awesome. Thank you very much. Are those icon stored ships? Some of these show different places you can go. Like, some of them are like flying ships that you can land on, like a flying aircraft carrier. I just don't know exactly where, because I know I have more ships. I have every ship in the game, but I guess it's about where you parked it. I don't know why we can't just like call it out though and like change ships. Unless it shows here where our ship is. Oh, unless we can fast travel there. I wonder if it shows where our ship's stored. There's a ship store, there's an upgrade store, there are available products, passenger transportation required. I think there's a symbol that tells you where you have a ship, but I can't tell. But I should have the other ships available. Flying some of the bigger ships is nice, but I don't know exactly where to get those. That's all right. Let's try to fly cargo to another spot. Bridgepoint requires transportation. But to where? Nord, okay. Let's see if we can transport a person to one of the newer spots on the map. They want to go there. Well, I don't know if we'll be able to make that one. I want to be able to buy the second. I want to be able to buy the aux and then transport. Like go into VTOL mode and go all that distance. Should be a way to do it, otherwise we gotta transport light stuff. Well, let's transport some cargo. And while we're here, we can recharge. Nice. Yeah, we'll transport some cargo. We'll see how that goes. Bum, bum. Bum, 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 bum. All right, so we should be able to pick up cargo. I don't know if this ship actually can go into VTOL, though. Like, I think you should be able to switch the mode. That'll make it a lot easier to get there. But man, once we get the bigger ship, that's going to be cool. The ox and the... I think the other one's called like the whale or something like that. Danny Tolman becoming a raptor egg. Welcome aboard. Thank you very much for clicking the tab of that join button. Big O coveted shout out to you. Thank you for the nonstop support. Appreciate it. Let's get some hashtags. Danny's in chat too, by the way. I keep forgetting to give you guys those hashtags. Oh, somebody remembered in chat though. Awesome. Chat remembered. That's awesome, guys. Thank you. What lovely chat members you guys are. That's why we have the number one chat on YouTube. Number one. All right. So let's turn around so we can buy whatever we need to.
Sub to my channel because it's all about me.
Absolutely, Billy. Oh, we can only buy rations here. Let's see what other cargo we can transport.
New subscriber shout out.
Oh, they need to go over there. Okay. Oh, we actually have to have money in order to buy them. So we got to start with passengers then. So we can only do passengers now. Let's see. Yeah, activating the VTOL takeoff is really cool, but then there's a way where you can put the engines into like airplane mode. Oh, I think our ship is damaged. It's actually smoking. Oh yeah, the hull's at 32 because I had some rough landings. Because I was thinking we were going to change ships and I got a little rough. Caused a lot of damage. That's a lot of damage. Yo, Triton 1000 with the little raptor. Thank you very much. Just love this guy. Hey, I love your support. Let's get some hashtags going for Triton. Thank you very much for clicking the tab of that big O join button. Beautiful. Yeah, you can actually ride the slipstream. That is true. There are wind. That's a very good point. There's wind that'll blow behind you. That is a very smart big brain. Let me go back to the map. I need to be able to see what's different around here. Yeah, that's the how to fly. That's the menu. I gotta remember how to just see the map. I guess we'll do it with the M key. That makes it easier. Okay, so we are at there's passengers at Bridgeport that want to go to Nord. Okay, we'll set that as our destination. Wait, they're at Bridgeport? Oh, I see. Got it. You can't really set, like, waypoints. You have to do it one at a time. All right, let's go over there. Nice. There should be animals and stuff in this update too. There might be like whales and fish and stuff down there that we can see. Maybe land-based animals too. On occasion you do land like not at bases. Sometimes there'll be like a damaged ship or something that somebody had to land down in the like down in the desert. So you got to go and do maintenance for them. The slipstream is when wind blows behind you. And then it makes your ship go faster. Kind of like a tailwind. Sometimes if you've ever ridden on a plane and they talk about having a tailwind. You probably heard that before. We better get some in-flight meals going. Wow, that was a landing. I guess this one's like, this island's a lot more fun to fly on. How do we open the cargo hold? There we go. All right, climb aboard, ma'am. So right now we're kind of like a, basically like a flying van. We can either transport a few passengers around or get cargo. Cargo gives more money, but it's difficult because it's much more heavy. All right, so let's set destination. The Nord. Nice. Oh, there we go. Oh, she's sleeping now. She fell asleep on the ship. She must have been watching a live stream. She wouldn't have that problem if she turned on the notification bell and never missed a live stream. Just saying. Just saying. Yeah, I think the other ship other than this one is much, much better. It's big, much bigger than this one, but it's not the biggest one in the game, so you can still maneuver a lot without too many problems. And it can use some of the runways, too. Man, Space Iceland is looking crazy. Crazier than the fact that chat's almost up to 275 likes? Holy crap. Whoa! Bam, do you want to get off now? All right, there's my stop. Thank you for the flight. Oh, you got it, ma'am. And there she goes. Yeah, we're basically in Iceland right now. It's Space Iceland. Space Norway. Space Scandinavia. It's amazing how much fuel we go through, though. Empty G-type batteries. Where would we transport those to? Yeah, it's like Space Uber. Yeah, that's a good way to look at it too. Yeah, Space Uber. Let's go to... from Nord to where? We can buy cargo here. And they want it to be transported to... back to Bridgeport again. Okay. Yeah, Death Stranding, except you actually get a ship. Yeah, that's right. All right, let's buy some batteries. Wow, that cargo is thick. It's kind of like Star Citizen, yeah, like when you're transporting cargo. That's why I like that game a lot, because you actually get to get out of the ship. But it'd be cool in Star Citizen if you could actually do local transport, too. Like if you could buy vehicles to stay on a planet and get your way, like make your way around a planet and not leave it. That'd be kind of cool. Whoa. Oh, yeah, I got to remember, we're a lot heavy now. Oh, up! Oh. We got too close to the geyser, I think. We die. We die now. Oops, we die. Aw. The geyser is really close to the airfield. That's right. We got insurance. Star Citizen Amazon Prime Driver? Dude, I would like that. Like, I want to be able to do that in Star Citizen, is to have ships that don't leave a planet, but that you could maybe put on a ship. That'd be kind of cool to have, like, local transports that could be loaded onto another ship that could transport them around, like a mobile hub or something like that, to deliver stuff a few different locations or something. What's going on? I'm not even flying. The AI is doing this. This is autopilot. What is going on? Oh, there it goes. All right. Can we pick a different ship? Oh, they won't ever give me the other ships. We own them. I just don't know where they are. Unless it's in my other profile somehow. Let me check real quick. Let me check my other profile.
We're pleased to announce that your first customer is awaiting your arrival at the spaceport. Flight data transferred on board.
Oh wait, this is like the very beginning of the game. Before any upgrades or anything. Okay. Let's go back to that other account. Bum, 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 bum. Wow, the Billy is strong, dude. That is a very strong Billy. Very powerful. All right, let's do the batteries again. Oh, now we're too broke. Oh, wait, no, those are rations. Is there a passenger here? Cargo's good, but cargo is, it's quite difficult without a bigger ship. You almost want the bigger ship to transport anything. Although it's not necessary. Actually, let's check the map again. They have cargo here. And they have empty batteries. Okay, we'll go do that one again. We'll try to not fly directly into the geyser this time. Although, if you guys have you guys ever played American Truck Simulator or Euro Truck before? One's in chat if you've played, like, a game where the physics change when you load up with cargo. That's pretty much how this is. Like, if you've ever loaded up with cargo before in a game, the vehicle really changes once you've loaded up. I like this ship, though. It's been a while since I've had to use it. I like the AUX a little bit more, though. But again, there's three ships in the game, so that's pretty cool.
Hi, Chad. Billy Nelson here, and you're lucky I'm here.
I know. A nice landing. All right, let's charge up. Oh, wait, are we supposed to go to the other place? Let's see. We're at Bridgeport now. Bridgeport has, pretty much nothing. So we got to go to Astaland Central to go pick that up. Okay. That's what we got to do. What's up, Matthew Thomas? How you doing? Okay. So we want to go to Astaland Central. In a game like this, how do you compensate for extra weight? Well, you just give it more thrust. It is capable of transporting cargo. But also, you can upgrade your ship to have better thrusters or larger batteries. Like, for example, my ship is blue, so I've made a few changes to it. You can customize with paint and stuff like that, so that's pretty cool. Lady Shiva with the 10. Whoa. Thank you very much. Let's get some hashtags going for the lovely lady. Holiday was good. Thanks for the support. I certainly ate a lot of food like I expected to. Nice. Good landing. I wish there was a way to do like a 360 turn. But I guess you do that before you land. Otherwise, you have to do a 42-point turn like me. Let's try that again. Okay, let's try this for real though. All right, we need to go back to Bridgeport. Let's make sure. Yep, so we gotta go back to Bridgeport. So we can basically transport these like 100 times, or we can get a bigger ship and do less transports. But basically, they're sending batteries over for recharging. All right, let's go. You can also play this with a joystick, but I'm playing with a PS4 controller. Reminds you of Starship Troopers? They are coming out with a Starship Troopers game. Trying to come down slowly. We got a lot of weight on our ship. That's a lot of pizza rolls. Wow, chat's up at the big 300 likes. Holy crap. Good job, chat. Now I gotta find where to land. You're gonna pick this up. It looks easier than Elite Dangerous. Yeah, both are pretty fun. This is cool though, because you're on one planet. I'd like more games where I'm on one planet transporting stuff between like research bases and military bases and mining outposts, and sometimes you're transporting like literally just water for people to be able to have fresh water. Well, that was something. Bum, bum. Ooh, homemade egg rolls, crab ragoon. What? How come I wasn't invited over? What the hell? Wow, you were getting that fancy with egg rolls, crab, lo mein, fried rice? Oh my, wow. So now those batteries that we bought, we can actually sell here for 1,406. Yay! We made money. Finally. I just want to be able to figure out how to... I gotta remember how to get to some of my other ships. I'll have to... This is the type of game where it might be a good idea to do a cheat profile, just so you can see, like, all the... Like, the hidden... Not the hidden stuff, but, like, the late game stuff and see what it's like to work up to it. Last thing you'd want to do in this game is, like, work really, really hard and buy something that, like, kind of sucks in the game and then just, like, not be able to do anything. She's a vegetarian. Oh. That's still good though. I'm down with noodles and veggies. I wouldn't complain. Okay, let's go get another job done. So let's see where else we can travel. I really want to be able to... This is a very small island, but that's, again, a very small part of the game. This huge island over here is where all the action is. But you don't really want to go over there without the other ships. What if we could take out a loan in this game? I don't think there's a way to take out a loan. Let's see. We could buy rations from, what's the name of that place? It doesn't say. Oh, that's Aslan Central there. This is a base here, but it's called like something spaceport. Looks like they all have symbols too. Bridgeport. Oh, actually, I think that's Aslan 1. Oh, that's what it is. Okay. Aslan 1. Wow, look at that. The second ship is over 2 times as heavy as the other one. Costs 28,000 credits. That's a lot of credits. What if we buy rations there? Where do we transport those from? Oh, we only... Wait, we only get 850 credits for that? That's a scam. What does Aslan Central want? Oh, they need rations. Oh, they'll pay 4,000 for rations? Oh, okay. I take that back. Let's go pick up some... now we're an Uber Eats driver. Members, where are we going? What food place should we stop and buy? We gotta swing by the drive-thru for our next mission. We're doing DoorDash. Where are we going? What do you guys want? You better hurry up and pick, Chan. I'm not going to 2 places. I'll turn this car right around, I swear. All right. I think we're going to Wendy. Oh, it's either Wendy's or Taco Bell. Oh, members, now is the time to pick. Wow, and you guys are almost up to 350 likes. Welcome again to all the new subs and such. Yeah, it really does feel like a survival game with the aspect of, like, trying to transport around water and food as basic resources. It means they're not so easy to get. And that the planet is still being, like, discovered and researched. Wow, that was a beautiful... Yeah, when it comes to going to the drive-thru, I can manage that. El Capo with the 5. Been a huge fan for years. Thanks for all the awesome vids. Well, thank you for watching. Let's get some hashtags in chat for our lovely Big O Crazy Super Chatter. Thank you very much. Show them some love. This ship is called the Scarab. All right, we just bought 850 credits worth of Wendy's. I hope chat's hungry. Wow, that is a lot of spicy nugs. It's a biofactory engaged in terraforming, spring bacteria, and all that. In general, a lot of people, and they all want to eat. You know what I gotta do? I gotta ask the people who make this game if they'll let me be a voice actor in this game. I should do a voice. We'll make a space drive-thru in the game, and I'll tell them. I'll do the voice when you... You know, when you go to make your order at the window. Yeah, I'm using a controller. I'm using a PlayStation 4 controller right now, though you can use a... I've also
How
used
do I join
a
the Discord. Check down below in the description.
A Thrustmaster 16000M, but also it's capable of doing it with a mouse and keyboard. But I would say the controller is probably the easiest, but the joystick is the best because it gives you the most overall control, especially of some of the larger ships. But this makes things a little bit easier. Yeah, thanks again, El Capo. If you guys haven't become members yet, too, by the way, I'm trying to push members like crazy this year because I'm trying to unlock more emotes for all of everybody in chat, or at least all of our members. Plus, I got a lot of keys to games to give away and such, so... If you want a key to, like, for example, this game, I can always ask the devs. Ooh, a little bit of leg. Ooh, 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 ooh. Hold on. We're fine. This is fine. We're good. And I can always try to do more giveaways for you fine folks for all of your lovely support. Because I like doing giveaways. It's fun. I always like when the winner messages.
Oh, you're looking to join.
Excellent.
Click or tap the join button next to the subscribe button now. Whoa, what the hell? Well, like the engine cut off for a second. I got scared. All right, Wendy's delivery is touchdown. Woo! Ah, there we go. You need to play Jurassic World Evolution? Good thing we already did. But everybody who's a subscriber and who's a frequent of the channel might already know that. So make sure you check it out. If you haven't subbed already, I would recommend you subscribe. Check it out on the channel. Because I would love to see you watching that one. I like that game. Wendy's is here. All right, so basically this guy's telling us that they'll buy tons of rations. So this is our hot spot for food delivery. We're already up to 6,000. What else can we buy here? Waste products for 420 credits. That's some pretty dank credits right there. Is this basically truck sim with ships? Yep. It truly is. All right. Aslan Central. And where would we transport the waste to? Ah, the port. Okay. And they'll buy that for how much? Whoa, 1600? Okay. All right, let's take that job. Yeah, this is basically like ATS as well. This is the smaller ship. I actually kind of miss this ship. I'm glad I'm kind of being forced to use it. Yeah, we're going to need a lot of toilet paper for all this bio waste. All right, so we got to go to the port next. Here we go. So the port is 3 kilometers to our east. That game looks cool with the controller, though, because the controls are quite smooth. We got to go around these geysers and everything. This is what Star Citizen needs, though, is the ability to transport cargo to and from different planets, but then also another job in between to transporting them on that planet. Like, that'd be so cool. Like, imagine if you could drive, like, a giant delivery truck or something like that. Like, huge. Like, building a base or something. Oh, that'd be awesome, too. Like, in-game events to build stuff. That'd be awesome. Wait, that's Nord. We don't want to go there. Where's the port? Is the port on the other side?
Welcome to our growing center. I'll trade in floors urgent.
Oh, there it is. I got bit by the Star Citizen bug. I like that game a lot. It is totally incomplete and not finished by any means, but what they've done so far is really promising, and if they keep delivering little by little, it's going to be amazing. And it makes me want to see this type of stuff in other games, like Farming Sim, for example. Like, it'd be so cool to be able to bring stuff to a factory, but then also, like, do things at the factory with, like, forklifts and stuff. Wow, that was a sexy landing, baby.
Woo!
That was nice, boys. Hell yeah. Number one pilot on the planet. Hell yeah. All right, let's sell that waste product. And recharge. All right, what can we buy from these guys? Real pearls. They're selling pearls? Where would we take that? Who would buy pearls from the port? Port Esteel? Dude, I forgot how fun this game is once you start getting into it. How much will they buy pearls for it? Aslan 1. We're playing Star Citizen again tomorrow, by the way. So if you like this game and haven't seen Star Citizen, that game's really fun too. Wow, they'll buy it for $8,425. Oh boy. Okay. Well, that's cool. All right. Well, let's make a purchase then. I like how also it gets loaded up, too. Like, you can actually see the cargo be loaded. And I think the cargo boxes look a little different each time, although they're always just kind of a crate. It'd be kind of cool if it, like, looked like containers or tanks or batteries or something every once in a while. That'd be neat. All right, we're done here. Go to Aslan 1 or Aslan Central? Aslan 1, I think. Yep. Extremely fragile load. Okay, we gotta be very careful. Any thoughts on Star Citizen versus Elite Dangerous? No, they're both good and you should get them both. I feel the same way about Star Citizen and Elite Dangerous like how I feel about ATS and Euro Truck. Well, maybe that's not fair because they're kind of the same, but Star Citizen is great because you can get out of your ship and go walk around and do a lot of that stuff, but Elite Dangerous has that coming. Elite is more polished, but Star Citizen is more promising. Either way, I think you'll enjoy both games. But wasn't Elite Dangerous free on Epic Game Store recently? I hope you all got that game. Elite Dangerous was free. Mud Runner is free right now. If you want to get that, a vehicle driving game based in the mud and stuff. If you don't have it, make yourself an account right now and go download Mud Runner. It's awesome. Seriously, Mud Runner is an amazing game. And SnowRunner's good, too. Make sure you use the code RAPTORIA anytime you buy something in the store if you want to support me. I would appreciate that. Let's do a first person. This is YouTube playlist right now. Yeah, I want to play more Elite Dangerous. I was going to play it again recently, but then I thought, no, I'm going to wait until the new DLC comes out. Or the new update, I should say. That looks cool. Yeah, Star Citizen is a lot of fun. Dude, the last few times I played Star Citizen, all I do is, like, walk around. Like, I don't do anything. And I love it. Like, all I do is I wake up from my apartment, I go down and, like, have a burger, or I meet Alex in his spaceship, and then we go walk around, and then that's the stream. It's like, dude, this is a space exploration game where I'm just going to, like, I'm going to a car dealership to, like, look at the cars that I can't afford. It's awesome. We do that in real life. Hey, you guys ever go to a boat show or, you know, like a classic car show? And it's like, oh, this is the only car ever made from this manufacturer. They only made one car. And you're like, wow. The price of this is $400 billion. Oh, okay. Like, it's fun. It's fun to go look at stuff that you'd never buy or that you can't afford. It's almost like being in a museum, honestly. Like, if they ever do you know, you guys ever go to the back to the 50s or 60s or 70s car shows? It's a damn museum. Yeah, the DeLorean. Well, if you get into the DeLorean, you can actually go back to 1985. And you can call it actually back to the past, but not the future because you're going backwards. But I guess if you went to 1955 to go back to 1985, you'd be going back to the future, to the past. The ride, the game. Dude, what if they made a Back to the Future Netflix series? I'd actually kind of be down to see what they could do with that. It doesn't have to have any of the original actors. I'd just like to see what they would do if they explored the world. With Martin... What's his name? Martin McNatt and Doc Gray or something like that. Pretty sure that's their names. In the G-Lorian. Pretty sure. Yeah, his name is Marty McDouble. All right, let's make some money, baby. Whoa, we got $11,000 now? It actually doesn't take that long to get started in this game. Like two or three more deliveries, and I think we might be able to deliver... We might be able to deliver the other thing. So let's deliver more B2 rations to whatever that place was for 4,000. So basically, you can just do this loop the whole time at the start to make money. Otherwise, you can always transport passengers. But it seems like there's a pretty good loop, like deliver food from the starport to the base, and then waste from the base to the port, and then pearls back to the spaceport for exporting. That's a pretty damn good plan. Alright, so we gotta go to Aslan Central to the port, and then back. Dude, this is awesome. This is the type of game that's much more fun to stream because with chat we have something to talk about while I'm flying. It makes the trip go a lot better. Yeah, there's runways in this game, too, where you can actually take off, like, your loaded 747 cargo ship or something. All right, guys, Taco Bell's here. That was a pretty good landing. Give myself 8 out of 10 on that one. Dude, what's that new thing they got at Taco Bell that's... It's not new, but, like, they brought it back. It's like the cheesy chalupa or something like that. I kind of want to go grab one of those. What's it called? Like the cheesy cheese. The Cheddar Chalupa Crunch. Baltimore's my man. Kind of want to go have one of those. Oh, these guys don't have any waste for sale at the moment. Okay. Well, we'll go find different cargo. What's got Nord got? VPN? Let's see. They're selling empty batteries. That goes back to Bridgeport. Does the port have more... Oh, those are too heavy for me. G-type batteries is what they want. Oh, actually, if they want G-type batteries... Oh, it's too heavy, though. They want me to deliver object... That's 2400. What else you got? Well, the batteries are always a good one. Let's do that. We'll do the battery shipment. Do Bridgeport. Well, we have to pick that up from Nord. So from Nord to Bridgeport. Cockpit's pretty sweet in this game. Although I think it looks the same on every ship. The chalupas have less salt than the regular taco. Oh. Thank God, a game where it doesn't get completely dark at nighttime. I think this planet has multiple suns, so it doesn't go completely dark. Slow that rate of descent to 10. There we go. Oh, they don't have third person in Elite Dangerous? I can't remember, do they? Oh, what the hell? This is fine. Oh, that's annoying. I wasn't over the geyser. I was next to it, but apparently you gotta time that much better. That's fine. We'll do it again. You can move the camera out, but good luck flying. Oh, you're not able to do that? Oh. I didn't know you couldn't move your camera around in that game. Yeah, now we're in a flaming hot Cheeto, that's right. Actually, now that we're back here, we might be able to get some other cargo. Like the rations again and deliver it again. You can't really die in this game. What happens is your ship explodes and then you basically get another one. You do have to pay a little bit of money though for your insurance premium, but that's fine. It's just like life. You can lock your cam to the ship outside an elite, but it's a bit difficult and not optimal. Oh, that's annoying. Maybe this was more of a strategy. Chat's almost up to 400 likes. Good luck to everybody else spamming that like button. That's awesome. And thanks you guys for spamming the notification bell and turning that on, and also spamming the subscribe button so that way you guys know what games we play in chat. It's great to see that everybody's subbed and checks the channel in its entirety to see all the stuff that we've uploaded. All the games. Pretty much every game ever. And don't forget to click or tap that join button to become a member. What? You're going to keep missing out on extra bonus stuff like free giveaways and members only chat? Okay. Well, I guess. Yeah, YouTube needs to stop the duplicate message spam. That's a real problem on YouTube. You just joined the Discord? Excellent. Yeah, the link's down below. All right, let's see what we got here. Yeah, I'm looking forward to Odyssey. That's going to be fun. All right, well, now that we're here, let's see what we got for new cargo. Ah, more rations again. Fantastic. That'll make us some money. So back to Aslan Central. And we are good to go. You'd think at this point in this game they would have like designed like a train system to go through the mountains. Like, these bases are only like 2 or 3 kilometers away from each other. You'd think that they would have like built underground, but I guess all this volcanic activity and stuff's made it so that way they don't really want to do anything below ground. Yeah, with all that thermal activity, good luck, yeah. So I was a little surprised with my last landing. I was like, oh, the geyser's going off, but we should be super clear of that, but I guess not. Go. Oh, the longer we wait, the more expensive an item becomes. Okay. So if we keep trading the same things, we can do it, but they'll pay less money for it. I see. Alright, let's go back to Nord again. This time we'll approach from outside, so we don't make any more trouble. What is this woman telling us to do? I think she's telling us to stop. Well, this area is certain death. There's a volcano, and then there's geysers. Why would you build a base over here? I think she's talking about what to do when you subscribe. You know, I'm gonna stay far away from that. Now this is just a random YouTube playlist. It's like an official copyright-free thing from Susan Wojcicki herself. She was like, hey, Dino Man, cool channel nerd. Hey, play this music or I'll ban you. Like, okay, Susan, please. Please don't hurt. Oh, this is what Susan's telling us YouTubers to do when it comes to making videos. Susan, can we take a break or will the algorithm punish us? But Susan, please, I have a family. Can I take a day off or will the algorithm punish me? No, Susan, please. Courtney Campbell, thanks for becoming a Raptor Plus. Let's get some hashtags going for our lovely new member. Yeah, this beginning area is nice. If you goof up and just like totally explode, it's not a big deal. It really helps you to learn. Anybody thinking about getting this game tonight, by the way? Who may have seen it for the first time, or maybe you've been wanting to buy it for a while? Well, if you're putting hashtags in chat, you got to put hashtag Courtney. Give her a shout out now. Don't forget. All right, let's go back to Wait, where are we on? Oh yeah, Bridgeport. Even though Bora is indicated in green, but I don't know why. Maybe they pay a lot more money? Let's go check that out. Or maybe I just marked them for some weird reason. It is nice in a game just to transport cargo and not really worry about combat or whatnot, whatever. It's just about making money by transporting stuff. Like, it's an honest job, you know? Pick up thing, drop off thing, and do it again. Upgrade your ship, buy a new ship. Put a logo on the side of your ship. Yeah, we're a space Uber. Okay, we're good, we're good, we're good. Oh. Where's that one girl in chat who says she delivers food or something? We're being that girl right now. The smiley face girl? Do you have a sign in the cockpit window? Yeah, it says out for lunch. Gone fishing is what it says. Oh yeah, there's the smiley face there. Oh, did she hear me talking smack? No, not talking smack at all, dude. All right, so it looks like they'll only buy batteries for 115, so we just went here, like, just to see. So we should go to Bridgeport. Bridgeport will buy it for, like, yeah, 1,000. What are the other places? Nord? Aslan Central? Oh, they won't buy it. But Bridgeport will. Can I see your comments? I certainly can. What should we call my transport company? Dino Dash? Oh, whoa, what the? Oh, okay. Oh no, not this again. That's one thing I find annoying is that sometimes it's really hard to see where the hazards are. There is actually a way to fix the vehicle. Hold on. Chat, we're going down. We'll probably crash, but there is actually a way where if you take damage and you're going down, or if like you're in mid-flight and you have to land, you can actually call in drones to help repair you. Yeah, the geysers are a little tough to see sometimes, because if they're in a crater and you don't see it, it's not like a volcano where there's constantly stuff coming out of the sky. Yeah, the only thing that happens is when that happens, it's just a little annoying. That's about it. Oh, we could buy upgrades, though. What does the suspended batteries do? Batteries are the latest innovation, increased power and capacity. Air drag plus 10, but capacity 450. Nah. What does this do? Speed plus 50. Ooh, we should buy that. Higher class landing gear. Or better engines. Power plus 25, consumption plus 30. Oof. Well, let's get those two and see how it works out. Let's get some upgrades going. Yeah, crashing's no real big deal in this initial area. Oh, look at that. It actually animates parts being taken off of and put back onto your ship. Oh, that is so cool. Dude, that's badass. I don't think I've ever seen another game do that. That's cool. All right, let's get the upgraded engines now. It's going to clip our wings.
We're pleased to announce new upgrades for your ship. You
cool.
Can find them at the cargo spaceway hangar. Price includes free installation by our qualified mechanics. And we will
let's buy the batteries. Oh, dude, now we're getting all the pimped out upgrades. Sweet. The only thing is, I think for certain ships, you can't bring your ship anywhere. I think, like, when we get the ox and the bull, we have to go to specific places to upgrade it. Speaking of upgrades, Corinne upgrading to a Raptor Plus from a regular member to a Raptor Plus member again. That is awesome. Thank you very much for the support. Yeah, I don't trust droids, though. No droids. Krista knows. She knows the way. It is the way.
New subscriber shout out.
Okay, let's charge up. I was a little nervous about this game with a controller, but it actually it's really slick. All right, now we got an upgraded landing gear, upgraded engines, upgraded battery. Let's see how this goes. Although the engines don't look too different, but apparently they are. Oh yeah, we went from 850 battery power to 1300, and we can transport more cargo. Hell yeah. All right, what can we pick up at Aslan 1? Oh, they want pearls again. Does the port have pearls? No. But they'll take G-type batteries. Holy crap. Oh. That's a long way to go, though. What does Nord have? Just passengers? Let's try... They want G-type batteries and also waste products. Does Aslan Central take that again? Oh, they don't have anything at the moment. Let's see. Yeah, we can fly over the ocean. I just need to get a different ship to do that, I think. So there's Nord. That's got a passenger. Bora. No, that's Bore. Where's Bora?
YouTuber, when is the Fortnite stream?
Tomorrow, Billy. Okay, Bora and Nord just have passengers. So I guess we just take cargo from here. That'll be much easier. All right. GMAC becoming a Raptor Egg again. Look at all those members returning. That is awesome, guys. Thanks for renewing your membership. Yeah, if you were a member once, you can renew and pick up where you left off. We'll have more giveaways and stuff coming up for the holiday season, so if you haven't yet become a member, now's a great time to click or tap that join button. Smuggle contraband. Yeah, chat's smuggling some illegal lemons right now. So don't snitch me out. Don't do it, chat. And chat's almost up to 450 likes too. Yeah, no lemons, only likes. No lemons, only likes. All right, let's do another Wendy's run again. Actually, let's deliver Arby's this time. We're gonna take about $8,000 worth of beef and cheddars and drop them off. Or 800. Dude, I forgot how fun this game is. I'm glad I came back to it because I've been in the whole Elite Dangerous, Star Citizen, like ATS Euro Truck vibe lately. Now let's see how the upgrades do versus the other initial, the other ones. Ooh, she is really responsive. Nice. Oh, you want a chicken cordon bleu? Yep, I'm sending it in. Dino Dash is on the way. Does the ship have a name? Well, we could name it after the next Raptor Ultimate member. That's what we usually reserve the big names for. Okay. Oh, we got waste products again. Nice. Well, we'll deliver that to the port. We'll go waste products with $1. Actually, it's 420. Dank Kush. We have ourselves some Dank Kush. Can we load that now? Wait, why is it not letting me buy it? Oh, wrong button. You're intrigued now? Yes, it's a good game. Luckily, we didn't take any damage at all. So we had a nice landing. Boom, boom. Let's see. I think we've loaded up with everything. Wait, can I take the batteries? Oh, we might actually be able to... Oh, we have a higher... Oh, items does not fit. Never mind. So our ship is too small, but we would be able to transport it. Weight's not the problem, but size is. All right, let's go to the port. I'll take a sip once we get to our destination here. Boom, boom, boom. Ooh, there's a sample there. I think if you stop and pick those up, you actually get a ton of money if you deliver them to the research sites. Every time you look at the stream, I'm parked. Well, our flights right now are pretty short because we're only on an island. But when we get to the other island, it's essentially the size of a continent. But now our ship is pretty upgraded, so we have quite a bit of cargo capacity and, or at least ability to transport heavier cargo. So we might be able to fly over to the other continent. If I could figure out how to use VTOL mode. Well, hopefully we make more than a dollar with this one. All right, we got to scoot over a little bit.
New subscriber shout out.
Oh, the last star. Thanks for subbing. Appreciate it. Welcome aboard. Okay, let's offload the waste product and recharge the battery. Looks like they don't have those pearls here at the moment. Oh well. Okay, let's see where else. Oh, it shows you big eruptions going on, so you can avoid that. Aslan Central. Just requires rations again. Oh, they're producing the G-type batteries. Oh, empty batteries. What does Bridgeport buy empty batteries for? I think it was like 2,000. Bridgeport. Oh, 1,400. Okay. So Aslan Central back to Bridgeport. Let's do that. I think if we actually stop and pick up that sample, we'll get a ton of money, but it may have disappeared. It might disappear. Oh, yeah, we've played No Man's Sky before. Plenty of No Man's Sky videos on the channel, that's for sure. All right, so we're going to pick up batteries and then transport them back to Bridgeport. Oh, the sample's still there. Well, chat has almost gotten to 475 likes. Let's see if we can push her up to the big 500. Also, if you guys aren't following on Twitter, I'm going to drop a link, too, where I'm going to give away free games. If you're not following on Twitter, you're going to miss out. Don't do it. Don't miss out. Also, Instagram and our Discord, too, are great ways to say hello to our community, myself, and also win more free games, too. So let's go ahead and drop that in the chat. That would be cool. All right. Let's get those batteries back over there. There's a lot more stuff to transport in this game. We've only seen one of the small islands, so keep in mind this game is much bigger, and there's much more bigger ships too that we'll have to work our way up to eventually. All right, off to Bridgeport. Or Bridgepoint. Bridgeport. Bridgepoint. Boop bop. Beely bop. Yeah, these engines are much more efficient. These are good. That cargo box there. I've not seen that before.
Greetings. Thanks for choosing our base.
Must be like a passenger where you can take it from one place to another. Nice. This, this, like, white outline of where to land is about as big as the biggest ship is, so it's about, like, two or three times our current size, which is crazy. All right, nothing else for sale here. I think to pick that up, all we got to do is, like, land next to it and then try to get it with the crane that comes out of the back end of the ship. What else do we have? They want pearls. Let's check the port. Nope, nothing yet. These guys still want rations, and they'll buy it for $16.59. Sample of native flora for only $2,700 now. That's not really worth a lot. They want pearls again. Oh, we can buy another scarab now. We can finally buy ourselves again. I think the only thing we can keep doing now at this point is either go to the new island or keep delivering rations, which they'll buy for $1,700. So it's probably good for us to wait for a while or try to make our way to the Big O Island. But we probably want a bigger ship for that area. Like that area makes that place look like this if you get the ox. What? Are we? Oh, we're almost to the big 500. Chat's got a way to go though. I don't think we're gonna make it, unfortunately. Chat is quite a ways away. I don't think it'll be possible. Chat could never possibly do that by clicking and tapping the like button right now, turning their like button to blue. It's impossible. All right, what does Bridgeport have? Nothing. Maybe a passenger. Although I don't know if you can see how much they'll give you. Oh, 1,800? Eh. Ah, we could do a passenger, I guess. Oh, he just wants to jump. Oh, this is easy. We get $1,800 just to go across? You can monetize every move in this game. An abrupt stop. Where does he want to go? Does he want to go to Nord? Oh, he does. Okay. I thought he wanted to go across the gap, but all right. We'll take him on a nice flight. Seems like a good idea to go around the radio tower. Wow, that was like record fast. Whew. There you go, sir. And away he goes. Use quite a bit of more power when you go fast, but going fast lets you get more jobs done in a short amount of time. And in this short amount of time, we saw what was new to, or at least now that we know what's new to Frontier Pilot Simulator. We can come back for another stream and try to take a look more at the animals and such. On their Steam page, it covers a little bit more what's new and whatnot. So if you want to get this game, check Steam, and we'll come back another time to do some more of this game. We'll try to all hack in some money so we can take a look at the medium and big size ships. And we'll see you guys tomorrow for more Star Citizen. And maybe we'll come back with Frontier Pilot sometime again in the future. You guys are amazing. Thanks for the support as always. And I'll see you all next time. Have a good afternoon, good evening, and good night. Make sure you sub, turn on the notification bell. Don't forget to smash like. And if you're missing out on becoming a follower on Twitter, make sure you do. I only talk about games and food there, just like we do in the streams. So make sure you follow me there so you can find out breaking news first on giveaways, new games, trailers, and more. And also follow me on Instagram and come say hi if you haven't. Everybody's welcome to follow me there and say hello. I'll see you guys soon. Goodbye, everybody. Have a great day.